because of adventure scientists, the entire world was now available to study. Adventure scientists expands where we can go with the research.
Adventure scientists was recruiting extremely capable people in the wilderness.
Going to places where other people generally don't go.
Giving us the ability to look at organisms in habitats that we had not been able to. Pretty much anything's available now.
Here in the Olympic Mountains, there have only been 5 martens documented since 2015. So the question is, why aren't they here? Pacific martens are very small. They're the size of a squirrel. As the years went by and we did more camera surveys and we still weren't getting any martens in the Olympics, we wondered what was going on. Adventure scientists made a huge difference. We were able to survey a lot more area, accumulate a lot more data, and then apply for money to do even bigger survey efforts.
What we do is we study these microscopic fungi that live inside plants, and we use those fungi to make drought-tolerant crops. So what was most remarkable about working with adventure scientists on the Mount Everest project was that that was an environment that had not been studied previously. So we had no idea, when you get to that extreme an environment, whether the plants in fact were symbiotic with microscopic fungi or not. At the end of the expedition, the stuff was shipped to us. It was in perfect shape. It was done exactly how we asked them to do it. And we dissected the plants in a sterile environment, so we didn't contaminate them with anything. We saw these fungi growing out of them. And what that told us was that there were no limits to this symbiotic community that's out there. It's everywhere.
In this lab, we're interested in solving the antibiotic resistance problem, and we're doing that in a number of ways. We can get a lot of antibiotic-resistant microbes from patients and hospitals being treated for antibiotic-resistant infections, and so we can see what they look like at the DNA level right now. What we know less about is what they used to look like before they became resistant. And so we're traveling the world collecting all kinds of samples, everything from animal scat to insects and other kinds of samples, and especially in areas where humans haven't applied antibiotics. Adventure Scientists does a great job of explaining what the approach is and how to package samples as best they can, given the challenges of being in extremely difficult and remote locations.